Hello, everybody, what's going on? This is Will here, and we are back with another episode of Pokemon Heart Gold. I really like Mahogany Town. I thought I had my favorites nailed down earlier in the LP, but you know what? I keep liking every town more and more. Mahogany Town reminds me of... This place actually kind of reminds me of home, too. Don't you agree? Aw, yeah, she looks very happy. It's a great Michelle Ruff. Michelle Ruff evolved in the last episode. That was a big thing, man. That was a big, big thing. But yeah, I do like Mahogany Town. I think it reminds me of home because there's a lot of... It looks like the kind of place where there'd be a lot of old people living. And, you know, PEI is kind of a retirement region. People go there to live out the rest of their days, whatever they have left, you know? It's kind of the place it is. It's the Florida of Canada, more or less. Let's see here. So this is the route we took up to the Lake of Rage, where that mysterious guy was hanging out. But, we didn't miss it, I just skipped over it. We skipped over a left route that you're able to take that, gives access to a couple very welcomed goodies, so we're gonna make our way over. But first we have to fight this guy who has, Magikarp and two Gyarados, I'm pretty sure. We'll know for sure after this, I guess. It's either a Magikarp and two Gyarados, or two Magikarp and one Gyarados. Two Magikarp. Okay, no, it is just the... It must just be the one, then. Or the two, sorry. Good lord. I had two chances there, and I said the wrong one. There we go. Let's see what that does. Alright, we'll get the two-hit kill. Surf from a Gyarados? Whatever. Yeah, who cares? That was a critical hit, man. You would've only gotten, like, 7 damage on me. Screw you. You suck. Oh, yeah. Oh, what? How did we not get the friggin' 3 hits? That gosh darn damage variation. Well, I guess we just have to use Magical Leaf again, because that's all Michelle Ruff has. Oh, I'll have to turn off battle animations, too. I forgot to do that from the last episode. Our gym battle with Jasmine. It did not go at all as I, like, initially planned. But, oh, it is 2 Magikarp. Look at that. But, I don't know. I got some good reception from the battle. People thought it was noteworthy. Which is super cool. I mean, that's just a prime example of, you know, upsides and successes happening when you least expect them to. I wasn't expecting much from that gym battle when I saw how awry it was going. But, yeah, people, I don't know. Few people complimented me on it. Which is super nice. Thank you very much. I'm glad you guys enjoyed it. So... That's what it's all about, man. It's all about just getting your back scratched. Don't worry about scratching mine. It doesn't get itchy very often, and that would be kind of weird because 56% of my viewers are males. So, I mean, thanks for the offer and everything, if you're offering, but I don't want people to get the wrong idea. That's all it is. Okay, I'm done. Don't worry. What am I doing? I don't know. I think I was going for a super repel, even though I think I already activated one of those. Yeah, okay. Good one, Will. Getting yourself all unfocused again, like always when you start talking. Which you seem to be doing a lot lately during Pokemon, so... Maybe this is good for you, this is healthy. I forgot all about this. I completely forgot that the maze is a friggin' swamp now. Or like a water maze. It used to be a cut maze. But now it's all about that water. So does that mean... Oh, that means that this area is accessible from the main body of the lake as well. That's interesting. Alright. Ooh, very nice. Very nice. Oh, I'm digging that, dude. Oh, I like that one. It's got sort of a powdery... Ooh, no, that one's cool, too. Oh, man. All these indescribable symbols just keep getting cooler. I like that one. It kind of looks like a Mr. Roboto kind of look to him, you know? You see what I'm seeing? You seeing that? Oh, that's nice. I like that. But that one looks cool. It kind of looks like... It looks like Leaf Storm. That's what I like about it. It's got that sort of look to it. Here, Let's do this. I think that's a corrupted Pokeball up there. Yeah, okay. Perfect. TM43, secret power. Not bad at all, actually. The question is, who would I give it to? And I'm definitely giving it to Bumbles. Because Bumbles would take very nicely to a nice, potent, normal-type move for coverage. So, we'll give it to Bumbles. Let's see what we can get rid of here. We can definitely get rid of Pursuit. I mean, that's not very useful, so we'll do as Mark Twain said. We'll kill our darlings. We'll kill our babies. Alright, so now that we got that out of the way, we should... okay, actually, you know what? At the other end of this, this thingy over here... Oh, repel wore off again. This is getting scary, man. I'm gonna run out of repels by the time I'm out of here. Even though I can just fly to the Lake of Rage, I guess. I can fly to the location. Which is a bit of a weird addition, but... I'm glad that they included that. The ability to fly there. Man, there's a freaking item over there. Whatever. When I fly to Lake of Rage, I'll just go over there. That'll be easier. Let's just go whatever which way. Freaking, ugh, this maze, man. This maze is the worst. It's not even hard, it just sprawls so many, like, lengths of screen. So it's kind of hard to keep track of what's happening. There we go. This should be the way we're going, yeah. This is where I originally was. Like, over by that item over there. Good lord, Will. Missing an opportunity just because you decided to go the other way. A new power has awakened. Let me share my power with your Pokemon. Take this, child. TM10. Hell yeah, man. Do you see it? It is hidden power. It draws out the power of Pokemon for attacking. Yeah, man, we know all about that from Pokemon Ruby, dude. We had a whole episode dedicated to friggin' hidden power detectives. That was a badass episode, man. I loved it. It was great. Alright. So now we're going to... Actually, yeah, this will be the part where we'll just fly to Lake of Rage. Yeah. Gotta take a drink out of my Tim Hortons coffee with a smiley face drawn on the top. Ah, tastes awful, but whatever. Yeah. One of my, What's the relation? My sister's boyfriend's cousin works in at the Tim Hortons that we stop at every day on our way home from school. And every time we see her, I think my other super repel ran out. Oh no, okay. Yeah, so we stop by every day after school and pick up our coffee from there. And like, you know, my sister and her boyfriend's cousin, like, they just always joke and stuff, and, you know, they put on that whole, like, best friends that act like they hate each other kind of thing. That's what they do. So today when we picked up our coffee, I picked up a large cafe mocha, and my sister picked up her medium tea with milk and half a sugar. And ooh, is that Choice Specs? I keep interrupting myself. Was too. Look at that. Well, gee, I wonder who's getting that one. That might not have been the best idea. Maybe I shouldn't do that. You know? Maybe I should let Michelle Ruff keep the Miracle Seed. Actually, you know what? I'll hold off on the Choice Specs right now, but when Martha Stewart evolves, there we go. That would be a good Pokemon to give to. Okay, I'll finish my story. Because it's not even that big of a story. When we got our coffees and everything, I got my cafe mocha handed to me first. And when I got it, it had the little smiley face drawn on it. And I was like, oh, cool, who's working in there? And I looked in, and I was like, oh, it's Michaela. And then when my sister got her coffee, it had a face, like a poker face emoticon, but with X's instead of just dots for eyes, and it said "You're dead to me" on the top of it. And the other worker just looked at her like, what the heck? Like, jeez. Like, what is this person doing? She's gonna get fired. And then my sister was just like, nah, it's fine. Nah, it's good. It's fine. Yeah, it's fine. Ah, we had a good laugh out of that. Maybe it's one of those things where you'd have to know the girl to really get it. Maybe it's, I'm almost positive it was one of those things. But anyway, we're challenging Ace Trainer Lois, who's being a reverse tsundere, I think, if I was reading that right. She was going like, it's not like I'm angry or anything. Like, oh my god. God forbid if you were. Shut up, Will. Oh my god, man. Alright, I got Bide going. I've got the Bide. I'm running Bide. Get it? Running Bide. At a breakneck pace. Okay. I'm gonna take another drink of my coffee while I wait to see where this Bide takes me. Alright. I forgot to turn off battle animations again, by the way. So this is turning out pretty well so far. And Shuckle's paralyzed. Useless. Not useless at all. I'm just, this was probably just not the best matchup, Hero. But I wanna see if I can do it, though. Stop! Stop it! Well, see, now the friggin', special defense just keeps going up, so it's like, what do I do? I could send Bumbles in, I guess. But I want to go for the Swagger. You just keep using Charge. What's your deal? Like, Charge... Does Charge stack? I don't think it stacks, really. It only stacks the special defense, I think. And as soon as you use an Electric-type move, that special defense goes away. That's the weird thing about Charge. Another weird thing... I never ever thought to look this up, I don't know why. But in Gen 3, that was when Charge was introduced. But I never bothered to look up if, even though... Oh, what's this gonna do? Wow, 9 damage. Man, that was strong. Jeez, that sure was good. I never bothered to look up Charge from Gen 3 to see if it actually calculated the special defense boost or not. Because it doesn't give the message saying that you... got the special defense boost, but I wonder if they kept that in, or if it really did just, like, double the power of your electric-type attack. Never bothered to think about that. Also, I also wondered why, they've never made, like, a charge equivalent for different types. Also makes you wonder. Probably just because boosting moves are so overpowered, you know? It's like, what's the point? Really? Unfortunately, what is the point? Good lord, man! This is the longest goddamn battle against a Mareep in history! In history, man! History was written before this battle was over! Alright. I've got the plan. I'm the man with the plan. She's gonna snap out of confusion, just like I predicted. Rightfully so. I wake up, Swagger. Boom! Plus 4 attack? Better not hit yourself again. It's also a shame that you don't have any physical attacks right now. Jeez, that sucks. That sure does suck. Alright, let's just go for the rap, man. The rap. Oh, don't have to go for the rap. Cause Mareep's dead. Oh. Dude. And Shucky's got like the extra experience going. That's great. Oh dude, this is a good matchup too. Ninetales and Rain? Oh man, you're being too good to me, game. Nasty Plot? I don't care. Do I look like a care? I don't care. Let's go for the Swagger. So this is pretty much my central strategy with Shucky. The main place I always found Shucky was most useful was actually in Pokemon XD, because you get access to Toxic and Encore, and Bide, and Rest. It was amazing. You could transfer him over to Emerald or Fire Red and Leaf Green if you wanted to give him Mud Slap. But even in the original games, I was probably him at his best, because he would get access to the Swagger TM and the Rest TM and the Mudslap TM and the Rollout TM. Oh, so good. So good. So good, man. I can't even explain how good it was. So amazing. I don't think I would ever, like, redo the Let's Play in concept per se by, like, going back and replaying, like, Crystal or something. Because, like, the games are a lot different. The remakes are a completely different beast from the original games. But I still don't know if, I don't know. I don't know if they're quite different enough to warrant, like, pretty much the same game twice. But, I don't know, you can say that about, like, any Pokemon game, though. All the Pokemon games are the same. But a lot of the strategies and routines that I'm used to usually in a Johto game are completely combated by the fact that I'm playing the remakes right now. So I feel a little bit out of my element, but still familiar because it's Pokemon. Oh, what now? Oh, I hurt myself. Good. Flamethrower is fine. Let's see what that does. Ooh, that's not good. That's not good at all. Let's try switching to Martha Stewart. Let's just get this freaking battle done, man. Oh my god. You'd think this was an episode of the anime with how long we've just been gawking around with this one trainer. Jeez, that Team Rocket's gonna pop out of nowhere. Of course I'm burned, of course. Cause you know, people will just burst into flames in rain. That actually totally happens. Don't take my slam as a valid slam, because that happens. But, the point is, this is bull honky right here. Am I gonna kill this Ninetales in one hit? Probably not. Probably not. I'm actually kinda surprised that I did. Maybe I shouldn't be surprised, but I am. Because that just doesn't happen. Well, look at that. Martha Stewart usually doesn't just kill something in one hit with a special attack, but I guess it happened. What do you want? Okay, you're just talking about an outbreak. Alright, cool. Well, let's end the episode off over here by talking to this dude. Let's talk to the mysterious man. Let's have Shucky looking at his Dragonite. Wait, I got an even better idea. There, perfect. Look there, look. We're meeting up, dude. We're meeting up for the first time. That red Gyarados wasn't acting right. As I feared, somebody must have forced it to evolve. Did you come here because of the Wild Tales? Your will? I'm Lance, a trainer like you. I heard some rumblings, so I came to investigate. I saw the way you battled earlier. Will? I can tell that you're a trainer with considerable skill. I've been sitting here for the past 4 days waiting for you to come talk to me. It's been, like, longer than 4 days, too. That's the funny thing. Could you help me investigate? Of course. Excellent. It seems that the Lake of Rage's Magikarp are being forced to evolve. A mysterious radio broadcast coming from Mahogany is probably the case. And that suspicious souvenir shop. I'll be waiting for you in Mahogany. Will! Alright, man. Oh, snap, dude! Dude, he just flew the hell away! Shuckle, why can't you fly me around? Oh, he's holding something. Let's take this from Shuckle. What are you holding on to? Ugh, no one- the blue scale? is that off of blue Gyarados? Oh, it looks like Ralph doesn't want to talk to us anymore on the Poke Year. Gee, what a shame. I'll miss him. Mahogany. Mahogany Town. Wonderful, wonderful, wonderful. Nice, man. Back in Mahogany. Alright. We're gonna end the episode with one last little event we have to trigger, but first I just have to, like, you know, heal up and stuff, make sure I'm in top form for such an expenditure? I don't even remember what the friggin' word is. Expedition, I think, is the word I was thinking of. Or maybe it is expenditure. I don't know. Whatever. We're just going to the friggin' drugstore. Local Shoppers Drug Mart. Local Kmart Pharmacy. I don't even know if Kmart has a pharmacy. Target Pharmacy, there we go. Target has a pharmacy. What took you so long, Will? Just as I thought, that strange radio signal is coming from here. Aw, snap, yo. What's he gonna do? Man, he's threatening the dude with the glass. Oh my god, dude, he just, like, shoved him. Man. And Lance knows strength, apparently. Holy crap. Even that Dragonite's like, man, dude, I've just been outdone. Even though that's physically impossible because Dragonite. Look at this, man. What have we just gotten ourselves into? It's been a while since we heard from Team Rocket, but here we are just, like, in their headquarters. They've just been stationed in, like, an old person town. What the heck, man? What the heck, Shucky? Oh, don't go sniffing around. It probably smells like bad people. Don't. Come on, man, don't. Come on, don't. Come on, stop sniffing at the floor. Come on, man. What else are you gonna be doing? Okay. Hey. Jeez. I guess that Persian statue must be smelling nasty. Interesting. Let's find out what this does in the next episode. Peace.